In the heart of Victoria's Golden Triangle, once the richest gold ground on earth, it's a historic day for Brent Shannon and brother-in-law Ethan West of the Poseidon crew.
We're going to make history here, Ethan. We're going to make history, mate.
They're about to break ground at their brand new lease, nicknamed the Big Licence. At 2.5 square kilometres, it's the largest and potentially most lucrative project of Brent's 20-year career.
So, Eve, we finally got here, mate. We finally get to this point what we've been working hard towards.
Mate, hasn't it been a hurdle, buddy?
Well, this is the big day. I've spent a lot of time, effort and money to get to this very point right now. There should be some good gold there. History of this area is very good. And this is all virgin ground. I reckon we've got 10, 15 years or longer here. All right, Eve, now we're going to work out exactly where we're going to try and hopefully pick up this lead.
And this is where it's all happening.
This is Chisholm's.
Yeah.
This is the old sketch map where the old boys believed it continued.
Yeah.
Brent's 1905 map shows that the old-timers chased gold leads to the edge of the Big Licence fence line, but left the ground beyond it untouched.
Why they stopped at the boundary remains to be seen. Where there was no gold, they weren't allowed in there, I don't exactly know, but we're about to find out.
The dotted lines predict where the leads from ancient rivers should continue. Brent and Ethan will chase the Chisholm's flat lead first, digging near the boundary where the old-timers stopped over 100 years ago.
Well, what we need to find out, Eve, is that where does this probable course go? Does it go in this direction where the old boy suggests? You know, as you know, these leads twist and turn and they can turn around in a bloody U-shape.
Yeah, our best bet is definitely starting up here where we can see on the fence.
What I want you to do, me boy, is start sinking a bucket in the ground and we'll get cracking.
Beginning of the future.
Beginning of the future, mate. We don't know what this ground's doing. I don't know if it's rich, nuggety ground. I don't know if it's rich, fine gold.
The Poseidon crew use two excavators to shift 800 tonnes of dirt an hour. It takes the team 5 days to dig the 9 metres down to the ancient riverbed.
I couldn't tell you how many loads I've pulled out right now. It's a lot, and there's a lot of tonnage sitting up here. There's thousands of tonnes that we've moved.
What we're doing is genuinely prospecting new ground, trying to pick up the gold. The lead's a little bit wider than I thought. Basically, a lead is the old river stream, but within that, say, 30, 40 metre wide section, you might have a channel that's a little bit deeper than the other sides. Within that channel might be only 3 or 4 metres wide, but that's where the best gold's going to be.
This is 2 years of hard work come to realisation now that this is kind of make or break. My family is what I have to look after first before anyone else or anything else. So it's not wanting this to work, it's actually needing it to work.
Hey, Brady, I've just turned up, mate.
How you going there, Paulie?
Good, buddy. Looks like a good size hole.
In rural Victoria, the Poseidon crew have excavated for 5 days, digging 9 metres down to finally reach the virgin bedrock of Chisholm's flat lead.
Hey, Eve, maybe you might want to get the plant fired up and run some of that dirt.
Yeah, that'll be the key, mate. If we've got fine gold, it'll be worthwhile to bring it up and out.
Yeah, I think we'll do that, Eve.
We don't want to be throwing away ground that's actually got gold in it.
The Poseidon crew's operation has 3 stages. Brent excavates the layer of pay dirt sitting on top of the bedrock bottom of the lead, while continuing to search for the gold gutter. The loose dirt is then laid out in pads 10 to 15 centimetres thick and detected for nuggets by Ethan's father, Paul. Ethan trucks the detected pay dirt to the team's wash plant, where it's processed to recover the fine gold too small for the detectors to pick up.
One of the biggest things is, too, that I feel the pressure off is this plant here. You know, it's $1 million+ in equipment. And this is what Brent really trusts me with running, maintaining, and keep up and going. You can't win. I've just put the first couple of tons through, and now we've got an issue with the spinner just after fire up. So what the issue is, this should be all getting away in the spinner, and this shouldn't be building up and coming out of here. So we've got something wrong. It's backing up. It should be flowing out, but it's not. So
The spinner performs the vital, final stage of the gold recovery process. It uses gravity and centrifugal force to trap the heavier fine gold particles, while the lighter waste material is forced up and washed away.
Ethan just called me over. This is all blocking up. This shouldn't be there. It should be washing away. We think it's a pipe down the bottom there. We made a modification there. And I reckon it's tilted too far and this gravel's not getting away.
So all this just here, this darker section, half of the pipe is all just silt sitting there. We're gonna have to shut it down to fix it. So with that comes time, money issues. It's just, it's a pain.
We changed a part of the pipe just before we started and I think we've got the angle slightly wrong.
Brent's my brother-in-law. It's not just you're letting down your boss, you're also letting down your family. And you're not just costing me. Costing me partner, I'm costing me sister, I'm costing me family and my nieces and nephews. And that's the part that really I do take on board.
I've invested so many eggs in one basket over here on the big mining licence. If it don't pay off, I'm going to be in a world of hurt.
That's 120 tonne that we're not going to get through today and we won't make up. So in a pretty time-sensitive operation, it's not ideal.
So when the material was draining into here, it was banking up back into the spinner. This will help it get away quicker. It's gravity. And before it was slightly going uphill before it went downhill.
Yeah, that should be all right, eh? We can get a weld on this side, a weld on here, eh?
Every day is a challenge, but if gold was easy, it'd be worthless.
Look, this is the last sort of things that we really wanted to be doing right now. We wanted to be digging dirt and washing dirt, not doing either. But anyway, that's just the joys of this sort of business.
At any time, a $200,000 bit of machinery could really have a major problem, and that could set you back tens of thousands of dollars. So make sure you can get that machine fixed and get it back up operational, because if you can't, you're not going to be digging any gold out of the ground.
Very delicate for such a big machine. We fixed the pipe, we've adjusted a few things to make the flows a bit better. It's critical we get it right, otherwise we'll lose gold and we'll block up the whole system and cause us no end of headaches. But right now, time to run dirt, run tons and get some gold.
Over 1,100 kilometres south, in Victoria's Golden Triangle, it's the end of the Poseidon crew's first week at their giant new lease, on which Brent has staked the team's future.
We've had a upsy-downsy week. We're on about 60 ounces so far this season, but I sort of feel like the season's just started, even though we're halfway through.
Yeah.
Because if we can get all this up and running properly, mate, and get some tonnage through and get some digging done, I'm fairly confident we're starting to come across that gutter pulley. After finding those few bits off of that pad, the first detectable gold, I think we're not far off.
Yeah.
All right, so we'll throw it in. 0.23 ounces. So that's not much gold. But what it is, it's gold out of a virgin gutter. We're starting to come onto it. And Eth, how many tonne did we put through that?
That was 47.7.
Right, well, 47 tonne. Okay, what'd you get out of that, Eth? Tip her on, mate. Right, so we've got a total of 0.950. That fine gold leaf is about, I reckon, close to 3/4 ounce, if my math is roughly right.
Their first week at Chisholm's flat lead has netted the Poseidon crew 0.95 ounces of gold, worth nearly $2,500.
We haven't even made an ounce for the week, right? But we've got untouched ground that's now got gold in it.
Yeah.
Now we just got to find where the best of it is, get this plant running properly, get digging, get some more gold out of the ground, mate. This is untouched. Nobody's been there either.
If it keeps results like this, we're going to do it. We're going to do fine.